eye-opening journey at Labhasna. A regular day at the academy begins with physical training, mandatory for all officers on training. To make physical wellness an integral part of their daily routine, as well as instill in them a healthy means of venting out daily stress. As the fresh officer trainees enter the regimental routine of the institute, they're first exposed to a foundation course, a common course for entrance to the All India Services, Indian Foreign Service, Group A Services of the Union and the Royal Bhutan Service. Through a well-defined and pedantically designed curriculum, combining classroom tutelage with outdoor excursions, it aims at providing professional expertise, on-the-job training, and dispenses nurturing and appropriate values such as esprit de corps, amongst others. The Academy, on its part, inculcates among its trainees a common set of values and attitudes, cutting across inputs of different academic disciplines. In a rapidly changing world, technology is the fulcrum of good governance and effective administration. The foundation course is designed to equip the trainees with the latest set of tools of information and communication technology. An important component of this course is an experiential village visit, where the OTs are expected to observe and study the ground-level struggles of rural life by actively interacting with the residents and listening with intent. The foundation course is one of the most memorable periods in the lives of civil service officers. After the successful completion of the foundation course, the IAS officer trainees graduate to phase one training. This phase imparts a rigorous coaching of a wide range of subjects, enabling them to handle the many assignments that they shall be responsible for during the first decade of their service. An integral part of phase one is the Bharat Darshan. A six-week winter study tour, which gives officer trainees an opportunity to experience the diversity of India. They closely observe the functioning of numerous organizations and thus acquire a pan-India perspective of emerging socio-economic and political trends. The OTs are grouped in a team of 18 to 20 members, where each OT traverses nearly 20,000 kilometers across the length and breadth of the subcontinent, learning on the way his or her emerging role and administrative responsibilities in alliance with other services. Four zonal days are organized, on which the culture and cuisines of the OT's allocated cadres are explored. Adding to the fervor is the Sangam, the inter-services meet, a stimulating endeavor by the IAS trainees and varied other civil services of India. Spanning over 3 to 4 days, Sangam fosters camaraderie. The eventful phase one segues into yet another exhilarating period of district training, which combines learning by seeing and learning by doing. As the officers on training handle independent charges during this period, to consolidate all that is learnt so far and share experiences gained, phase two of the training program allows for interactive learning, enabling young participants to articulate the strengths and weaknesses of India's administration and governance and seek robust solutions to the present and future challenges. Formally, a sense of career that had brought them to the prestigious institution has now become a purpose of their life.